CSA members worried about their jobs once the proposed border control unit is established. A man arrested on illegal firearm and ammunition possession charges is remanded to Borderly. The deputy director of the island's lone correctional facility clears the air on the practice of homosexuality behind prison walls. And fresh calls for urgent action to stop the migration of qualified nurses. To you, welcome to the Tuesday edition of the DBS News World. My name is Timothy Polio. We commence the broadcast tonight with news that a border control unit proposed by Prime Minister Alan Chastney has left a few public servants unsure about their future once the unit is established. The entity will see the amalgamation of the Customs and Excise Department, the Police Marine Unit and the Immigration Department. DBS's Sheffield Gillard begins our news coverage.
The entity will operate along the lines of the United States Coast Guard. The St. Lucia Civil Service Association says it is concerned about its members' jobs once the proposed amalgamation takes place.
Any matter that would have impacted our members negatively must be of concern to the CSA. And so we must first have that discussion with them, let them know what the consequences are, and for they also to tell us what their concerns are. Based on that, we will know how to move from there. But in any circumstance, anywhere there is a transition in, where any employee has to reapply for the position, CSA must be of concern of that. Particularly when those persons have been provided with training and the government have invested heavily in preparing them to effectively manage the institutions that they are operating in, for they are now being told that they would have to reapply for their positions. That must be of serious concern to the union.
The union met with some of its members from the Customs and Excise Department to determine the way forward.
Today we call our members to a meeting to discuss something that we have been hearing about that would be have some impact on the unit, which is the customs unit. And so we're having a pre-meeting with them to gather information and to prepare ourselves for tomorrow, for the days to come.
The meeting was held at the headquarters of the CSA at st.lucia. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.
In other news, a 26-year-old man who was arrested on Sunday for the possession of an illegal firearm and ammunition has been remanded to the Borderly Correctional Facility. Kareem McPhee of Grosley was officially charged on Monday, August 13, 2018, for possession of an unlicensed 9mm Taurus handgun and 11 rounds of ammunition. He was arrested during a police operation at Bosaju.
McPhee is claiming that he found the handgun and ammunition in a plastic bag at Pigeon Point. He was arrested on Sunday, August 12, by officers attached to the Grosley Police Station during a routine operation near the Bosaju-Grosley Junction. On Tuesday, August 14, the young man made his first court appearance before Magistrate Leon France in Grosley seeking bail for the two offences. Kareem McPhee had no criminal record, and the prosecutor and the defendant's attorney, Albert and Richlow, saw no reason why bail should not be granted. As handed down by Magistrate France, McPhee is to surrender all travel documents to the court and is to report to the Grosley Police Station on Mondays, Thursdays and Saturdays before 6 p.m. He is not to apply for any travel documents or leave the state without the court's permission. The 26-year-old was granted bail on condition that he pay $5,000 for possession of the firearm and another $5,000 for possession of the 11 rounds of ammunition. He was remanded to the Borderly Correctional Facility until the fines are paid. McPhee is expected to make another court appearance on September 12 for case management. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.
Deputy Director of the Borderly Correctional Facility, Leonard Terrence, has sought to explain himself after an earlier statement by him was taken to mean that homosexuality is not practiced at the prison. Mr. Terrence says prisoners come from all walks of life and thus their sexual preferences would vary. He spoke to Don Nicholas.
According to Deputy Director of the Borderley Correctional Facility, Leonard Terrence, he responded to a question posed last week by indicating that he had not received any reports of homosexuality at the prison. But he acknowledges that homosexuality is everywhere, and it would be naive to think that it does not occur at the facility.
Some individuals may come to prison not even having that in their mind or even be leaning in that direction. But sometimes you may have situations where these individuals may very well be engaged in this kind of activities. So I am not oblivious or even naive to say that it does not exist, it does not happen.
Mr. Terrence added that when arrests are made, the lawmen do not inquire about the offender's sexual preferences.
Every day we receive our daily reports, but I have never seen a report that says, here is why we are moving an inmate, here is why we are transferring an inmate, here is what an inmate has done of that of a homosexual nature. So I have never had that report. But I am not naive, I am not oblivious to the fact that in some instances it may occur.
Once incarcerated, inmates are deprived of engaging in relationships with their sexual partners. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.
The National Emergency Management Organization, NEMO, held its annual general meeting today. A number of key stakeholders involved in disaster risk reduction discussed their plans to make St. Lucia a more resilient nation. More from Alex Buske.
NEMO's director, Velda Joseph, says such meetings are critical as St. Lucia is prone to many forms of disaster.
This is always a critical dialogue to have, because at the end of the day, if you are impacted, you want to make sure that the coordination is as seamless as possible. And to do that, you would need to know what obtains with the other agencies that is involved in the coordination. You would need to know what resources are available. You would need to know how the actions sync with each other. And so it's always a very critical dialogue to bring everybody around the table and to iron out all the kinks to make sure that we have a very seamless operation, both in terms of preparedness and in terms of response.
All government ministries, along with other key stakeholders such as Lucilec, FLO, SLASPA, Digicel, and the St. Lucia Chamber of Commerce, attended the meeting.
Following this meeting, it is expected that we will go out there and we will be able to address the challenges that we have highlighted. But importantly, it will allow us to make sure that our coordination going forward is strengthened. NEMO has advanced the development of a country work program for St. Lucia, and that country work program relates to disaster risk reduction, and it's across sectors. So it's not just for the NEMO Secretariat, but all sectors are considered in that work program. And so going forward, we will be able to advance as one in terms of implementing that initiative.
The NEMO annual general meeting took place in the conference room of the Ministry of Infrastructure. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Buske.
Still in the first segment of the broadcast, Street Vibes.
Hi, I'm Alex Buske, and you're watching Street Vibes. In this harsh economic time, do you think that medical practitioners should reduce on their fees?
Oh yes, I think so. Because some people, they have the money, but some of us do not have the money. And when you don't have the money, you have no help, doctor cannot help, you stay home and you die. So I believe very much they should reduce on the fee of patients that come to see them.
No, I don't think they should. Because of the profession in which they are in, I find that it has to serve its purpose. It has to be one that it entails professionalism, it entails getting a job. They have to be accurate. And in just how it is, how life is and everything that's happening, if you're going to charge them 100, if they are going to charge 100, 100 to 150, I find it okay. It's okay for what they are doing, because the medical field is just as important as any other field.
Of course they should.
Why do you think so?
Because it's kind of hard, and because of people cannot working, so they should.
Oh yes, they should. I think it's too damn expensive sometimes when you head to the doctor and then you cannot afford to pay.
So you think they should reduce?
They should. Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Why would you say so?
Because something is too hard, nothing is too expensive, the medicine is too expensive, and there are people that cannot afford to pay for it.
Do you think they should reduce on their fees?
Yes, they should go down.
Yes, they have to.
Why?
Because what happened, they have children that's going to school, the mother cannot afford, and then what I'll say again, the medicine too, yes. And another one again, people not getting job right now, thing hard in this country, right? So the medicine have to go down, everything. If we have, we'll have a real government in this space. Well, you have to bring everything down.
Yes, I feel it's time they do that.
Why would you say so?
Because I myself, like, when I go in and see doctor, it's the same medication I have to pay.
Yeah, well, you've just been watching Street Vibes of me, Alex Buske, down here at the Aquarius Crossing, the intersection of Coral and St. Louis Streets. With that, we'll take you back to our studio.
Thank you very much, Alex. You're watching St. Lucia's television and news leader and listening to us at Rhythm FM 95.5. We are also online on the big screen at the Aquarius Crossing in downtown Castries. Still to come, Wasco responds to public complaints about the company's approach to pipe repairs and the resulting damage to roadways. And the Met Services warns that things are about to get a lot hotter. Welcome back and thank you so much for staying with us. A call is being made for urgent action to be taken to clamp down on the migration of nurses and midwives from the Caribbean. The call is coming from the regional nursing body. Here is Don Nicholas with more.
The issue of nurse migration has been a cause for concern for some time now. Commonly referred to as the brain drain, many professionals, nurses in this instance, migrate to greener pastures. The issue resurfaced at the Regional Nursing Body's annual general meeting, where authorities expressed concerns about experienced nurses leaving the region in large numbers. The body called for urgent action to address the situation. According to officials, international agencies are secretly recruiting the healthcare professionals, prompting the body to call for urgent strategies to curb the trend. Officials say something must be done to stop the hemorrhaging of the trained personnel. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.
The water and sewage company Wasco has responded to complaints about the company's failure to repair roads after digging them up to carry out pipe maintenance. The company was blamed for some of the damage to a road in Independence City, which residents took on their own to repair this week. Here is Sheffield Gillard.
One section of the road which was badly damaged is believed to have been dug up by Wasco. The company has responded to the claims and has indicated that some of the works they undertake are unavoidable considering the infrastructure lies beneath the road surface.
I just want to reiterate that the water and sewage company is not responsible for the repairs of the roads. What is in place is a memorandum of understanding that we have with the Ministry of Infrastructure. And they are the ones effecting the final repairs and putting the asphalt back on the roads.
The MOU clearly states that Wasco is to inform the administrative and technical assistant via email of the incurred defects as soon as possible. According to Mrs. Williams, every Tuesday, at a time agreed upon by the two parties, a joint visit is done to carry out measurements and to prepare estimates for the repairs, which are carried out by the Ministry of Infrastructure.
As it relates to the situation in Independence City, the works were conducted by Wasco on one of the lines there, and the information with regard to the repair of the road was transmitted to the Ministry of Infrastructure. What happens with Wasco is that we refill the trenches that have been dug out in the road, but the final laying of asphalt is the responsibility of the Ministry of Infrastructure.
The MOU has been in effect since February 3, 2015. Wasco will be meeting with the island's chief engineer and other officials from the Ministry of Infrastructure in an effort to address the problem. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.
Earlier today saw the hosting of a training session for OECS technical personnel on hardening and weaning of coconut tissue culture plantlets. St. Lucia imports 2,000 coconut plantlets under the Caribbean Agricultural Research and Development Institute Cardi Regional Coconut Project. More from Alex Buske.
These plantlets must be imported as tissue culture plantlets for safety reasons, ensuring that no disease or pests are involved in the transition of the plants from one country to another. Therefore, local and regional participants are being trained on how to wean and harden these plants for the transition from a lab setting to a field setting and eventually the distribution to farmers.
Well, the market in each country is slightly different. In St. Lucia right now, it seems to be leaning more towards the water, as you said, and the jelly. But under this project, we're looking to revitalize the entire industry. So there will be market studies done to determine exactly whether St. Lucia requires more oil nuts or water nuts, and from that decide where we can increase production. Years ago, the coconut oil industry was pretty vibrant here in St. Lucia. I'm not too sure exactly what happened over the years, but right now a lot of those trees that give the copra nuts are very old, and so they're not performing as well as they would have, let's say, 10, 15 years ago.
Under this project, Cardi is aiming to replace plants and increase the production levels. Whether it's for the water or copra nuts or any other byproducts, then the market studies will come in and give data on exactly which one St. Lucia prefers and how much. The issue of rodents was also addressed.
The rat problem, again, we are looking at how we can deal with that, how we can introduce food and health safety practices, especially to the vendors, the coconut vendors. We've started the formation of a coconut vendor association, and we'll be doing training with them on these health and food safety practices to ensure that rats is not an issue. And from the agronomic perspective, we will work with the farmers for what they can do in the fields to reduce that problem.
Participants from Antigua, Dominica, Barbados, and St. Vincent and the Grenadines attended the training workshop at the Orchid Garden at Union. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Buske.
We continue the broadcast with news that the Heineken 2018 Green Synergy Competition has been launched. There's a lot that is new, which adds to the excitement surrounding this year's event. Sheila Mendez explains.
The Green Synergy Champions 2018 has been officially launched, and this year is expected to be unlike any other. The Green Synergy competition, which consists of the skills segment and the DJ Clash component, will now see the addition of the new Green Synergy Beats Boss series.
Now this year, Green Synergy is taking things to a completely different level. Not to mention the awesome grand prize that we have. So $80,000 for the skills segment and $8,000 for cash prize.
Another add-on to this year's competition is for the skill segment. The DJs must submit their 10-minute video demo mix to Green Synergy by August 19, 2018. From that, 16 DJs will automatically qualify for the semifinals. The Green Synergy Beats Boss series will be used to qualify DJs for the Clash segment. Heineken is very proud of the fact that they have been able to be pioneers and pave the way in opening up this industry for our local DJs.
I think Green Synergy has grown over the years. I think the good thing about Heineken, I think we are very proud of the fact that we were able to craft that industry. Gone are the days when it was about sound system and the industry was not about the DJ. It was like the power plant and the list goes on. But in the advent of Green Synergy, we were able to create that the industry for the DJs. We are able to showcase the DJs, we are able to give them their personality. And over the years, we have seen the likes of DJ Clears. And a lot of the DJs have gone through that system. And for us, it's a very exciting moment. Persons are very much, you could see what's happening out there. I mean, a DJ can earn a living by walking with a laptop on their back.
Heineken Green Synergy is a musical platform where they continue to amplify the beat. Awesome consumer prizes and a People's Choice Award for the DJs are just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to what is to be expected this year. The grand prize also includes $18,000 and $8,000 for the winners of the DJ Skills and Clash segments respectively. The Green Synergy Champions launch took place at the scenic Rudy John Beach Park Library. For the DBS News World, I am Chela Mendes.
Well, the DBS News World continues in just a moment. The Met Service responds to public concerns about the high temperatures. Many people have been complaining about the seemingly unbearable heat lately, but the director of the St. Lucia Met Service says the months of August, September and October are usually the hottest months and that there is nothing out of the ordinary.
That is the time of year that our temperatures go the highest. But the thing is that time of year also coincides with the time that we get rain. So sometimes when there is rain and there is a lot of clouds, you find that the temperature is kind of moderated by the presence of this cloud and rain.
The dry spell currently affecting St. Lucia, Mr. Descart says, is as a result of Sahara dust.
The Sahara dust, it impedes convection and it suppresses rainfall.
According to Mr. Descart, the dry spells will continue. To help ease the tension that sometimes leads to prison unrest, the Easy Cruisers Riding Club today presented 12 footballs to the Bordelais Correctional Facility for use by inmates. The presentation took place at the facility. Don Nicholas was there.
Members of the Easy Cruisers Riding Club attended a football match between the Bordelais Correctional Facility and Richfort. They were so impressed with the skills displayed by the inmates that they decided to make a presentation of 12 footballs to the facility.
And at the spur of the moment, our members came in together and said, hey, let us do something. And the guys gave a monetary contribution towards the individual. Another member asked, but what can we do to help the process? And a representative of the facility indicated that, hey, we could do some balls. So I'm very elated and happy today to present the facility with 12 footballs.
Deputy Director of the Bordelais Correctional Facility, Leonard Terrence, says the donation will help the inmates to get more involved in sporting activities and thus ease the tension that can easily escalate into riots and other forms of violence.
We have been using football in our programs for quite some time now in order to break that tension, to break that stress that sometimes inmates feel that they are under.
The presentation took place at the facility on Tuesday. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.
In other news, over the past decade, the increased traffic on St. Lucia's roads has meant an increase in road collisions and fatalities, many of them involving motorcyclists. Noting this, a few bike enthusiasts have come together to undertake a road safety awareness campaign. The campaign will take the form of a bike stunt show within a controlled environment. This has been scheduled for Sunday, August 19, 2018, from noon at the Darren Sammy Cricket Grounds Promenade. The general biker nation, as well as the public, is invited to come and support the initiative. Sports is next when the DBS News World continues. Time now for the usual reminder. CSA members worried about their jobs once the proposed border control unit is established. A man arrested on illegal firearm and ammunition possession charges is remanded to Bordelais. The deputy director of the island's lone correctional facility, Claire D'Air, on the practice of homosexuality behind prison walls. And fresh calls for urgent action to stop the migration of qualified nurses. as a broadcast. Thank you so much for watching and listening to the DBS News World. On behalf of the entire news team, I'm Timothy Poole. I'm wishing you a very good evening and inviting you to stand by for What's Happening Now with Laura. It commences at 8:30 tonight, right here on DBS Television. Good night and see you next time.